Dear students, in our previous class, we have studied about certain concepts of the lesson Components of Business Studies. Now, before going to the next concept, we are just memorize or revise our previous knowledge or previous lesson. How? Through question and answers. The first question is, what do you mean by employment? What do you mean by employment? We already studied profession, business, employment. Business, profession, employment. These are the types of economic activities. Yes. Do you know the answer? Yes, employment means it is the work undertaken by the people under an employer or owner, under an employer for salary or wage. That is called employment. Then the next question is, which are the important considerations did the producer take during the process of production? Which are the important consideration did the producer take during the process or course of production? Yes. What is the answer? Is. Can anybody? The answer is, during the course of production, the producer take into consideration about market. He should study the market situation, then about transportation, storage, about storage facilities, then about the price, fixing of price, then also advertisement. Therefore, about the market, transportation, storage of goods, determination of price and advertisement. These are the considerations the producer should take during the process of production. Third question is, how many stages are there in the evolution and growth of commerce? What is evolution of commerce means? Evolution of commerce is nothing but what? Improvement, development in commerce. That is called evolution of commerce or growth of commerce. We studied, I already told, there are 8 important stages. There are 8 important stages. Through this stage, the commerce developed. Still, also, it continues. Therefore, which are the 8 stages of evolution of commerce? First one, hunting and fishing stage. Second one, pastoral stage. Third one, agricultural stage. Fourth one, handicraft stage. Fifth one, barter system stage. Sixth one, money economy stage. Seventh one, town economy stage. Eighth one and last one, international trade stage. All these 8 stages are linked with each other. There is a close connection among these 8 factors. First stage is hunting and fishing. We already discussed. Now, what are the main features of this hunting and fishing stage? Write the features of hunting and fishing stage of commerce. It was the earliest stage of commerce when people lived in caves and tree holes. They didn't know anything about commerce. Here, the man was nomad. He was wandering in search of food. They hunted animals. Why? They hunted animals for food. Fishing was also their routine work. Besides, they also gathered fruits, roots and nuts. Nuts, why? To use as food. These are the main features of hunting and fishing stage. Now, the second stage is pastoral stage. Which stage? Second stage. Pastoral stage. Now, let us see what are the features of this pastoral stage. It is better than hunting and fishing stage. Somewhat certain improvement took place in this pastoral stage. Improvement took place among human beings. Man. Yes, now the first feature of hunting and fishing stage was he was nomad, wandering from one place to another place. You know the reason. In this stage, the man stopped that wandering life, not wandering life, wandering life. He stopped his nomadic life. He said goodbye to this. And at the same time, he decided to live in a group. Live in a group. Then he learnt here in this pastoral stage, man stopped this. Then he started to domesticate animals. Domesticating of animals means rearing of animals. That is the second feature. In the beginning, they domesticated. In the beginning means in the beginning of pastoral stage, he started the domestication of cattle, hasugalu, cattle. Then sheep, then goat. These animals provided food and skin. Food and skin. See, these animals, cattle, sheep, goats, they provide food to the primitive man. Not modern man, primitive man. Besides, it also supplied skin. Why did he need skin? To cover his body from various seasons. Cover their bodies. Next, they moved one place to other. Third one. They moved one place to other. Why? in search of food, in search of food and grassland. Grassland. Grassland means hullu kavalu. Why? To use or to domesticate for the rearing of goats, sheep and cattle. He moved one place to another place. Why? To find out the grassland. In this stage, man had reached some higher level in development. Higher level of development in this stage. Prior to the first stage, hunting and fishing, man was better in this stage. He was developed. He was developed, but commerce was not exist. Commerce was not existed in that time. He did not know anything about commerce. These are the features of pastoral stage. Next, third stage is agricultural stage. Third stage is agricultural stage. Agricultural stage. The very name indicates his job or occupation of a primitive man. That was none other than agriculture. He was engaged in agriculture. He grew different types of crops also. Yes, now agricultural stage, in this stage people learnt the art of growing what? Crops. Growing crops, the art. Agriculture is an art. Science is also there. In modern days, scientific agriculture is also there. But in primitive, they did not know about science. Therefore, they cultivated. How did they cultivate? We don't know. People learned the art of growing some crops. They did not move place to place in search of food. He learnt the art of cultivation in a fixed size of land. That was in forest. Human beings were settled in a fixed place. I already told, the man here stopped his nomadic life and he started to live in a fixed place. He did not move other places. He started his living in a fixed place, in a permanent place. He did not a wanderer. How did they live? They lived in a fixed place with the groups. Why? For the purpose of agriculture. The works of agriculture, it requires so many human resources. Yes, sir. Fixed places in groups. Then commercial activities started, yes, after cultivation. Next point is starting of commercial activity, buying and selling, exchange, etc. Commercial activities were started. The villages and communities came into existence. Simple form of division of labor started. Yes. Now, while living in a groups, there started communities. Communities, then society. Community, society is a group of people. Community is a group of societies. Thus, communities were started. Societies were started. Main occupation was agriculture. He started the commercial activities after growing different types of crops. Then a new feature of this stage was division of labor. Division of labor was also started. That is the new feature. This feature is, we can also apply in modern days also in trade and commerce. Therefore, what is division of labor? Division of labor means division of work. Division of work among workers. Among workers. For example, while stitching a shirt, there are 8 tailors are there. Imagine 8 tailors. They should stitch 1 shirt or 100 shirts. Among the 8 tailors, one should do only cutting. Cutting means cutting of shirt pieces. Another one stitching. Another one makes holes to put buttons. Then another tailor only put buttons to the shirt. Then another one for ironing. Ironing. Then another tailor only for the purpose of packing. That is called division of labor. Therefore, division of labor means it is nothing but division of work among workers. What is the benefit of this? The work is very easy here, and also work is very fast also. These are the agricultural features of agricultural stage. Fourth one, handicraft stage. Handicrafts stage. Handicrafts, handmade goods. Which were the goods? Only tools and materials. That is handicraft stage. Now, what are the features of this stage? We already studied here in the agriculture stage, the main occupation of the human being was agricultural. For agriculture. Which culture? Agriculture, people wanted certain tools, not stools, only tools. Why? To the purpose of agricultural, to cut the trees. They need materials or tools for the purpose of to cut the trees, plow the land and other things. Therefore, in society, majority of the people were engaged in the agricultural work. The agriculturists or farmers, they require tools. Therefore, certain people in that society or community, they prepared tools. They are engaged in preparing of tools. Later, they were called carpenters. Carpenters. Then, after the carpenters, different types of craftsmen came into the social life of this prehistoric man. Yes, to fulfill these needs, some people engaged in making tools and also construct house. Oh, living in a fixed place, now they started permanent living place. Permanent living place means they construct. They were ready to construct houses with the along with the use of tools. They are ready to agriculture along with the use of tools. Therefore, they are called craftsmen. Not only craftsmen, other smiths were also emerged. First one craftsmen, then blacksmith, weavers, builders came into existence. Now the community was divided into different work groups. Different work groups or working groups. They also carried on various products. They carried on various products to prepare tools. This craftsmen, they required what? Certain items means raw materials. Certain raw materials. They collected raw materials and prepared tools and supplied to the farmers. Farmers cultivated different types of crops and distributed among these craftsmen. Therefore, craftsmen, blacksmith, they were satisfied the needs of agricultural people or farmers. In the same way, farmers also satisfied the needs of these craftsmen. In return, the agriculturists provided them with their requirements. Yes, give and take policy. Farmers to craftsmen, craftsmen to farmers. Now, through give and take, giving and taking, a new system was started, that is barter system. Barter system. New system in commerce was started, that is none other than barter system. That is the fifth stage, that is barter system stage. We already studied about division of labor. What is the division of labor? Division of labor means division of work among various workers. Division of work among workers or division of labor among laborers. Division of labor, labor means work, among the various laborers. Laborers means workers. Now, the division of labor enabled a quick production of goods. Due to the barter system, division of labor policy, what was the effect? Effect was that production was increased. This symbol shows increase. Production increased. How? Due to the application of division of labor. These goods produced were directly exchanged. The direct exchange of goods for goods or other things is called barter system. Therefore, production was improved. The quantity of production is very high. Immediately, all the productions were distributed. Then started what? Barter system. What is barter system? Barter system means exchange of goods for goods. Exchange of goods for goods or other things. This is called barter system. How can you define barter system? Exchange of goods for goods, or direct exchange of goods for goods or other things. But this barter system, in the initial stage, in the beginning, it was very famous. Day by day, it became very problematic one. Why? It had certain difficulties. What are those difficulties that were existed in barter system? See, the first one is lack of double coincidence of wants. Lack of double coincidence of wants. What is a double coincidence of wants means? Here, people exchange only goods for other goods. If a person A has paddy and wants wheat, he has a large quantity of paddy, but he wants wheat. Person B has wheat but wants jowar. Person B has wheat but he wants what? Jowar. If person B wants paddy, the barter system was take place between A and B. A has paddy, B has wheat. Paddy, person A, he wants wheat. B had wheat, but he wants jowar. Therefore, the person A should search a person who wants paddy instead of wheat. That is coincidence of wants. It is very difficult to find out such people in a market. Lack of double coincidence of wants. This is the first drawbacks or demerits or problem of barter system. Second one, lack of common measure of value. Lack of, shortage of common measure of value. How can you measure a price of a coconut and a price of arecanut? Person A has coconut. Person B has arecanut. How many coconuts are equal to how many arecanuts? It is very difficult to decide. Therefore, lack of common measure of value is not possible. It was very difficult to decide the quantity of one commodity to another. How many coconuts are equal to how many arecanuts? How many arecanuts are equal to how many coconuts? To decide this, it is very difficult. Therefore, it is the second drawbacks of barter system. Third one, difficulty of subdivision. Difficulty of subdivision. To divide arecanut or coconut or any vegetables, it is very difficult. We should not divide any commodity or goods. Hence, how can we decide a rate of a coconut and a rate of 10 arecanuts? It is very difficult. Therefore, difficulty to subdivision. It is impossible to divide. It is impossible to cut a coconut and it is impossible to cut or divide arecanut. Therefore, there is no business between A and B in such a circumstances. Fourth one is difficulty to store the goods or to transport. Difficulty to store the goods. Difficulty to transport. For example, coconut. We can store coconut so many times. But we can't store ripe mangoes or ripe fruits for a long period. Therefore, it is a problem. That is the shortage problem of storage. Then it is very difficult to transport. It is impossible to transport a larger quantity of coconut and also larger quantity of arecanut or any vegetables and other items. It is very difficult. Therefore, it is the last drawback of barter system. Therefore, I already explained the four drawbacks of barter system. Sai Ram, we will meet in our next class.